Hi, I'm Kim from ScienceScope, and this is my favorite time of year, Halloween, because that's when I get to do spooky science. And today I'm going to teach you how to make a spooky drink for the season. So we will be working with dry ice, and there is always some precautions you need to take in science, and especially when you're working with dry ice. The first step is you get a cauldron like this, and you pour in apple juice. So that's your first step. You're going to do that. And then once you've filled your cauldron up two-thirds of the way, then you're good. And then the next step is adding your dry ice. Dry ice is frozen carbon dioxide. So that's what that is. And again, with my safety, I have my tongs here. You can do that. And this is it right here. So you just grab a piece. Obviously, you don't touch it. It will burn you. And you gently put it in your apple juice. It's doing two things. It's cooling it, number one, because it's so cold, and it's also carbonating it as well. So you turn regular room temperature apple juice into a sparkling, cooler apple juice. And now it's time to enjoy. So again, really, this is the key part. The most important safety issue here is that you do not consume any of the dry ice, not even a little piece. Two ways to do that is one, to let it all do its thing and exhaust, and then you just have, you know, what's remaining, which is the drink, and that's perfectly fine. Or if you're very careful, like what I like to do, is still enjoy it as is, as it's going on, but make sure you don't get any in your mouth. So a way to do that is with a strainer. You can do either a strainer like this or a spoon with a strainer is fine. I didn't have that today. And then you're just gonna have your cup, and you can put your strainer on top, and you scoop some out so that you don't get any of the dry ice in your cup. So then once you've done that, you're ready to consume. So this is my spooky Halloween drink. Cheers.